Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Kristen, and today I'm gonna be going over some common living room design mistakes you may be making in your home and how to fix them. If you're struggling to make your living room look complete and well-designed, I hope this video helps. If you enjoy watching, make sure you give this video a big thumbs up and hit that like button, and I wanna give a huge thank you to ThredUp for sponsoring this video.
I'm Kristen, interior designer and home decor expert. I'm sharing all of my designer tips and tricks with you to help transform your house into the home of your dreams through DIY projects, affordable home decor, styling tips, and home organization. If I can do it, you can too. Let's make our homes look and feel their best.
This first design mistake might be a little shocking, but if you're redesigning your living room and buying all new pieces of furniture and decor, there won't be anything very unique about it. Someone could literally just copy and paste your entire living room and have it at their home. If you want to have that unique style, one-of-a-kind pieces, and make your space feel very special, you need to start thrifting some furniture and decor. There is a reason why a ton of designers thrift different furniture and decor, even find vintage pieces to really add another element to their design. I love heading out thrifting to shop for little decor pieces to layer into my design. I have some thrifted frames, vases behind me. I love thrifting baskets and lamps. There are so many amazing pieces that you can get at a great price that will make your space look collected, special, and very unique. Every time I'm out thrifting, I usually just skip past all of the clothing and head straight towards the homeware aisle. I find thrifting for clothes very overwhelming, and I'd actually rather do it online using ThredUp. So thank you so much to ThredUp for sponsoring today's video. I know if you're trying to save money on clothing and find really unique pieces for your wardrobe, you would love ThredUp. ThredUp is an online thrift and consignment store that sells women's and children's clothing. It's the easiest way to thrift for your wardrobe. You can stay home, shop online, and it will arrive at your door. You can sort by size, brand, color, clothing item, and find exactly what you're looking for very easily. This is one of my favorite pieces that I found on ThredUp. It's a Zara dress that I actually remember seeing at Zara and missed the opportunity to buy it. So I'm glad I got a second chance. This has an estimated retail value of $46 and I got it for $27.99. I got this entire outfit on ThredUp for under $50. And this sweater vest is literally new with tags. It's from a brand called Dip, and it's originally $29, and I got it for $17.99. This shirt was so affordable. It's an Ann Taylor shirt that was originally $25, and I got it for $5.99. And these pants, they're originally from The Gap and have an estimated retail value of $70. And I got them for $18.99. I love this sweater. It's a Zara knit sweater, and the estimated retail value is $46, and I got it on ThredUp for $24.99. This is another piece that was new with tags, literally still has a sticker on it. I love little puffy sleeve shirts like this. This is from a brand called Universal Threads, and its estimated retail value is $20, and I got it for just $14.99 on ThredUp. This leather shirt is from Zara, and it has an estimated retail value of $60, and I got it for just $50.99. If you're looking for some new pieces for your wardrobe this season, definitely check out ThredUp. You can use my code KristenM to get an extra 30% off your first ThredUp order and free shipping. I'll leave the link down below in the description box so you guys can shop as well. Now, a huge design mistake that can just throw off the entire design of your room is incorrectly hung wall art. If you hang your artwork too high or too low, it's gonna throw off the entire design. Think about hanging your wall art at eye level. That's a natural height so you can enjoy your space as a whole. If you're hanging wall art above your sofa, make sure that it's about 12 inches away from your sofa and it doesn't get too much higher than that. Once it's hung too high, it won't look like it's designed with the sofa in mind as well. Now, that's usually easy to do when you're hanging one piece of wall art, but when it comes to hanging multiple pieces, that's when some other problems can happen. If you're creating a gallery wall like the one behind me, you need to make sure that you place your artwork close enough together and not too far apart. Sometimes when there's gallery walls and there's big gaps between each frame, it looks a little scattered and it doesn't look like it's meant to be together. I think 3 to 4 inches between each frame is a great distance, but you can also just eyeball it. It always comes down to those little nitty gritty details, but if you keep them in mind, your space will look a million times better. Now, I think every living room needs a focal point. This is kind of the purpose of the space, the main attraction, something to kind of gather around. If you are lacking a focal point, your room will feel a little scattered, lost, a little disorienting. Usually living room focal points are fireplaces. If you don't have that, maybe it's a TV. If you don't have that, maybe it's a window. And if you don't have that, you can make your own. Create a gallery wall or paint an accent wall behind your TV to kind of form the look of a fireplace. I also love the idea of mixing your TV into a gallery wall. It's kind of a way to make your TV look blended into the space and it doesn't just stick out like a big black box. Now with smart TVs, you can have constant artwork playing on your TV, so it really blends into your space nicely. That's a great way to have your TV and your gallery wall be the accent and focal point of your space. So if your living room right now is feeling a little lost and scattered, a little too separated, definitely consider congregating your furniture around a focal point or creating one in a creative way. Ooh, now onto a tiny little throw pillow detail that you need to implement into your home. If your sofa has throw pillows on it, but they're all the exact same size, it's not working and it's not gonna look like that well-designed space that you may be looking for. A very standard pillow that you probably already have is an 18 by 18 square pillow. If you have these lined up across your sofa, there's no dimension, there's no detail, none of them are really being highlighted on their own. So layer in different sizes and shapes of throw pillows. Go with at least 3 sizes of throw pillows across your sofa. You can layer in lumbar pillows, round pillows, large squares. Bring in those different sizes and shapes to add some interest and dynamic detail to your sofa. So style 3 different pillows at 3 different heights and sizes and they will look incredible. A well-designed living room always comes down to the little details, and a little detail that you cannot overlook is picking the right size coffee table. If your coffee table is way too small for the space, it will show. It won't look right with your furniture around it. Usually a lot of sofas and sectionals call for larger coffee tables, and large coffee tables can be expensive. So you can get that look for less by actually getting 2 smaller coffee tables and putting them together to make it look like it's the right size for that space. You can also do this with nesting tables, with round tables. You can bring in different heights and it will add a really cool design element to your space. You also have to consider the height of your coffee table. If your coffee table's too low, it's going to feel too small for your space. And if it's too high, it's going to make your sofa or your chairs around it look too small. So consider the size of the coffee table, the height of it, and if you need multiple coffee tables to bring together, that works great as well. Usually a living room is a very high traffic space, and high traffic spaces come with clutter. If you're finding your living room to be looking very cluttered and there's things everywhere and there's nowhere to put anything, you need some more closed storage. Closed storage allows you to hide that clutter away and make your space feel a little bit airier, a little brighter, and usually look a million times better. It's really hard to create a beautiful looking room if it's cluttered with your things. So I would say find closed storage opportunities anywhere you can. I have this little sideboard back here that has a ton of stuff in there. We have board games and little chargers and things, but it's hidden away behind the closed doors. I also have little baskets in there that I have remotes in and just things that get left out. Those little details allow me to hide away my clutter so that no one else can see it, but you can still access it very easily. If you have shelving in your home, it doesn't mean you need to fill it all the way up. That will make it look cluttered and look heavy. Once you remove some of those pieces, hide some of that clutter away, you'll be able to breathe in your space and it's gonna look a lot airier and a lot more beautiful. You can do this with kids' toys, books, remotes, chargers, keys, anything that is really filling up your space. I also really love and appreciate furniture that has storage built in. If you can get coffee tables that have built-in storage, benches, stools that kind of lift off the lid and you can put things inside. All of those great hidden storage opportunities are amazing for decluttering your home. And lastly, if you're looking for new furniture for your living room, do not make this last design mistake. Do not walk into that furniture store and buy the matching living room furniture set. Don't get the matching sofa to the matching chairs. It just ends up looking like a very dated, kind of lazy look. It doesn't make it look like you spent time and effort on your living room, and it just looks a little too boring. I would say bring in a new color, a new fabric option, new texture, to really bring in some interest to your space. If you have a matching furniture set right now, this does not mean you need to get rid of it. You can even move your accent chairs into your bedroom, maybe into your family room, split up the furniture around your home so that it's no longer a set. The sofa that I chose for this living room also had the option to get matching chairs, and I love the chairs on their own, but I didn't want to have a matching set in here. So I decided to bring in the same color chair, but a different fabric and a different shape. It introduced something new in here and something that adds a little bit more detail into the space. So take your time when you're furniture shopping. Find that one piece that you love and work off of it. Bring in accenting colors, different fabrics to tie together an entire design. All right, so that's it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed watching, and I hope this gave you some ideas on ways that you can improve your living room. If you're looking for even more design solutions and decorating tips, I'll leave a few of my favorite videos I've made down below in the description box. I know they will definitely help improve your entire home. And again, I want to give a huge thank you to ThredUp for sponsoring today's video. You can get an extra 30% off your first order and free shipping using my discount code KristenM. I'll leave the link to that down below in the description box so you guys can shop as well. Anyways, if you enjoyed watching and found this video helpful, make sure you give it a big thumbs up and hit that like button, and make sure you guys are subscribed to my channel so you don't miss the upcoming videos. Click that red subscribe button down below and make sure you guys have my notifications turned all the way on so you're first to see the next video. Love you guys so much, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye!